to three, when I count to three, I want you to dig way down deep in the very bottom part of your heart, that real compassionate, rich, thick part. When I say three, I want you to say yes. Okay? One, two, three.
It's just basic surrealism, you know, it's, it doesn't have to mean anything.
I mean, we're always going to try to take advantage of any medium we can, you know, use it, you know, in any way possible. We try to get images that just reinforce the song and the mood of the record, you know.
Anybody who's already listened to the album knows that it's about change, it's about evolution, evolving ideas. So if you look at the artwork, you feel that.
Well, I got into sculpturing and special effects and that kind of stuff because I was written to monsters when I was a little kid. And just been doing it. And the reason why I came to Hollywood and I met these guys.
Come from the music pretty much, so since music is a higher form of language, it's probably best to just kind of envelop yourself in the music, and more than likely the ideas will kind of envelop you. That's where the lyrics come from. Interpretation of those sounds. The sounds came first. The lyrics came after. If you listen to the music and you have your own idea what it's about, it's probably about that. For you. Because it doesn't matter what it's about to me. The music is speaking on its own. It's an exploration in sound, once again, like all the other songs are. You get a certain feeling when you hear the music. When you actually hear the lyrics, they're speaking about something completely different. It's contrary to the sounds you're hearing.
The eye of a father. Eine halbe Tasse Schnauzucker. Ein Viertel Teelöffel Salz. Eine Messerspitze türkisches Haschisch. Ein halbes Pfund Butter. Ein Teelöffel Vanillezucker. Ein halbes Pfund Mehl.
Maynard drew a friend from high school, and we started Tool. We started just jamming and not really taking the band seems seriously just playing for a hobby, or it's just a release of having a side. You know, I had a job, he had a job, and then we started kind of...
He moved in next door to me, and I got sucked in.
Right. We used to go see Green Jello, which Danny was in. Danny was in about five or six different music projects in that time, and from playing like with Carole King to being in Pick Me Love Circus and a television warm-up band and kind of a jazz prog rock band, you know, some of his friends, and then as I say, Green Jello, and we kept kind of asking him to jam with us, and he didn't want to, and then we actually had a chance to play with the drummer from Autograph, and he didn't show up, so Dan came down and filled in, and worked out.
And I was hooked.
Yeah.
And that was maybe year and a half, 2 years of touring after Anima, and then a you know, bunch of business to sort out and kind of get back into the right headspace to be creative again, and then just really it was a question of letting everything breathe, you know, letting all the ideas come out in the best way, and that's, you know, that takes a little bit of patience.
We're truly an alternative band. All the bands that seem to be labeled as alternative that I see are not alternative to anything. They're all doing the same thing. They're playing formulas and marketing themselves in formula-type ways. And you know, if you want to hear something different, then you can listen to Tool, because we play 8 or 9 minute songs, and it just comes from a different approach, you know. It's about the music rather than about selling a little piece of product to the people. You know? That's what it's about.
I think Maynard said it best, where he said, you know, a lot of the other bands are like commercials, and we're kind of like a feature film. So buy our album and buy some popcorn.
Yeah.